Hello everyone and welcome back to our channel The Teacher, and today we are going to talk about this responsive slideshow animation in PowerPoint. So I had created a preview of this animation in 2018, as you can see here, but didn't make the tutorial, so thought to create one today. And if you see this list here, that is, these are all my uncompleted PowerPoint animation projects, and this picture slideshow was one of them, so thought to complete it today. So let's get started. And here we have two separate presentations. One is picture slideshow and the next one is picture slideshow with custom shows. So you will get to know about the difference between both of these presentations when we will end this tutorial. And here we have our first presentation, picture slideshow, and here you can see seven different slides. And if I go to the animation span, then you can see that on the first slide we had not applied any of the animation effect. So what we are basically doing here, we are using the action setting in this picture slideshow presentation, and for that we created one of the slide first and placed all the content that we want, all of the pictures here. And if I show you the selection pane, then you can see that we only placed a few pictures here, and then we replicated the same slide by right clicking on the slide in the thumbnail view and choose duplicate slide, and then just change the action setting that I will explain you. So first of all, on the first slide, as you can see that we have also changed the colors of rest of the six picture, and this first picture is colored. And on the second slide you can see a few animation effects in the animation pane, and here you will also notice that we have applied an action setting to all of these six pictures. And to see this, if I go to the insert tab and click on the action button, then you can see here that we have applied hyperlink on mouse click on the second picture to slide two. So when someone during the slideshow will click on picture two, then the slideshow will head to slide two. And if I show you the action setting of third picture, then it corresponding to the slide three. And that way we have hyperlinked all the pictures to their corresponding slides. Like picture four is hyperlinked to slide four. So basically what we are doing here, we are applying action setting to all of these pictures except for the first one on the first slide. But if you move to the second slide and select the first picture and go to the action, then you will see that I have also applied an action to this picture as well, and that is moving back to the first slide. And for creating some animation effect, what we are doing, when someone will click on, let's say, picture number two, then what will happen? This picture will move to the left and this picture will get into the slide like this while growing and shrinking. Just two animation effect on both of the pictures. Grow shrink animation effect, where the picture will reduce to 80% in size and will auto reverse. And if you go to the timing tab, a very short duration of 0.25 seconds. And if I show you this one, then that is the smooth start. We are applying 0.25 seconds and nothing else, and a duration of 0.5 seconds. So let's say if I show you the slideshow and click on the second picture, then the first picture will move to the left and the second picture will get into the slide, and you will also head to the second slide on the presentation. So if I click on this picture, so that way we created seven separate slides representing each of the picture. And now we are on seventh number slide, and if I click on this first picture, then it will move back to the first slide. So if you click anywhere except for the pictures during the slideshow, then it will not have head over to the next slides until you click on these pictures. So if I move to the second slide and select this second picture here and go to the action, then you can notice that we have not hyperlinked to any of the slide. And same way, if I move to the third slide and select the third picture and go to the action, then again you can see that we are not using any hyperlink to any of the slide. And that is because, if let's say if I go to the first slide and see the slideshow, now if I click on the third picture, then it will move to the third slide. But if again you want to click on this picture, then it will not work. That's what we want. So that is why we are not hyperlinking those pictures. So that way, using the action setting, what we are doing, we are just looping the viewer into all these seven slides until he press the escape key. So let me show you once again. But there is a problem in this method, and that is, let's say, as you can see the animation here, but if I again move back to the first picture and the second, once the animation effect of those pictures complete and you again click on those picture back, then you will see no animation effect. You are just seeing the picture straight away, but no animation as they were appearing before. Let me show you once again. The first time when I run this slideshow and click on the second picture, then you will see all the four animation effects that we applied to both of the pictures. The first picture and the second picture that will take place of this picture. But once I complete all the animation effect and move back, then you will see no animation effect. And to resolve this problem, I had created a second presentation here with the custom show. So as I named this presentation picture slideshow with custom show, and if you don't know what are the custom shows in PowerPoint, then I had created a tutorial on how to loop animation with pause between each repeat. So if you might know that in PowerPoint, if you are repeating an animation effect, then there is no way to make a pause between each repeat or make a delay in the repeats. So for that I had created this tutorial. You can go and watch this video to learn more about making pause between the repeats, and you will also get to know about the custom show in this tutorial as well. So for now, let's move back to this presentation. And so basically, what is the difference between this presentation with custom show and without custom show? That is what I am going to demonstrate to you now. And let's say on the first slide, if I select this picture and go to the insert and click on the action, then you can see that I am using almost the same method that I had used in my previous presentation. So what is the difference? But if you go to the slideshow tab and click on the custom slideshow, then you can notice that I have created seven separate custom shows in this presentation, whereas you will not find these custom shows in this picture slideshow presentation. No custom shows here. The only thing matters here is that the name of these custom shows are similar to the slide name. That is why when I click on and select any of the picture and click on the action, then you here see that you might think that I am linking this to the second slide, but that is not slide 2, that is custom show slide 2. I forget to give a proper name to them, so that is why it is a little bit confusing. But you will see a difference between both of these presentations when I will show you the slideshow. So what I am doing here in this presentation is I am selecting all of these six pictures on the first slide except for the first one, and then click on the insert action hyperlink to this. This time I am not linking them to a particular slide. Instead, I am linking them to a custom show. And which custom show you want to link that picture to? And that is slide 2 custom show. Hit OK and OK again. And if I move to the slideshow section and go to custom slideshow, and here I go to custom shows, and if I select this slide 2 and click on edit, then you can see that it is linking to slide 2 by making a custom slideshow for the same slide number 2 and linking that picture to custom show instead of directly linking into slide number 2. And why I am doing this? That will make a difference in the animation. And that, what is the difference if I show you the slideshow? Now let's say if I click on the second slide, then third, fourth, fifth. Now all these links are the custom show links. And what is the difference? The difference is that you will not lose the animation effect. Doesn't matter how many times you click on this picture and in what order you click on them, you will always see those animation effects that we applied to both of these pictures, this one and the another one that will take place of the previous picture. So if I show you the slideshow of the previous presentation once again, then you can notice that it plays the animation only once, and if I want to repeat them, there is no way to repeat these animation effect by using hyperlink to slides. So that is why I use the custom slideshow method to demonstrate that what is the difference between using hyperlink to particular slide and hyperlinking to custom show. So I hope you will like this tutorial. Let me know by liking, sharing and commenting on this video. And you can also download these presentation, and link of these presentation are given in the video description. So thanks for watching, and I will meet you in my next tutorial. Have a good day.